They're a rare find. So rare, only five have been recovered in Florida. A meteorite that lit up the skies last month over northern Florida actually made it to the ground, and a bit of that meteorite has been found. Channel 4's Rebecca Berry spoke with a meteorite hunter. It's a story you'll see only on 4.
It was a fireball that blazed across our skies last month, and it caught the eyes of dozens of people, many reporting what they saw to the American Meteor Society. One witness said, "I have seen many falling stars before, but never in daylight, never this large, and never this low to the horizon. It was magical." It was 10:30 a.m. on Sunday, January 24th. Meteorite hunter Larry Atkins happened to be on vacation in Florida and heard about the fireball. He teamed up with fellow meteorite hunter Mike Hankney and set out to find it.
He went ahead and forwarded me the Doppler radar returns and the AMS reports. And so once I had all that information, I knew exactly where to go.
Using close to 100 eyewitness reports and images from Doppler radar picking up on the meteoroids flying through our atmosphere, Larry, Mike, and a team of meteorite hunters began combing the swampy Osceola National Forest about halfway between Sanderson and Lake City. They searched for a month and found an astonishing 6 meteorites.
So Florida is a very inhospitable place. It's probably one of the worst places in this country to actually look for a meteorite. Here in Florida, you have all this moisture and salty air and, you know, humidity, etc. We got very lucky and we're very fortunate to find these 6 rocks, and all of them were buried except for one. And it's actually the first one that's a witness fall that was recovered through the efforts of meteorite hunters versus just happenstance of hitting a car or something like that.
You might not know this about me, but my first career choice was astronaut. My second career choice was meteorologist. And so I'm incredibly excited to have the opportunity to hold a meteorite. Most geologists that make a living out of studying rocks will never even get this opportunity, much less a regular person like myself. It is 4.56 billion years old and the rarest material on the planet.
Atkins says he sends these off to UCLA for classification and testing to verify the find. The rock comes from the beginning of our solar system, and there's nothing else rarer. Rebecca Berry, Channel 4, the local station.